from the horse's mouth. Our Neil Young News Report.
Smell the horse on this one.
With this week's update from thrasherswheat.org, here's Thrasher.
Hey, Thrasher here with this week's Neil Young News, and the fields still continue to be very quiet out there in Neil Young land, so not too much fresh wheat this week. But a little bit of news, we have the announcement of some of the bands that will be opening up for Neil Young Crazy Horse on their Australia-New Zealand tour that's going to be kicking off in March. They just announced the names of the bands, nothing that we're too familiar with. Bands by the name of Husky and the Drones. Not familiar with those guys. Certainly a band with the name The Drones is kind of topical, so I'd have to check those guys out and see what they're all about. Otherwise, things continue to be very quiet. So we'll just kind of move on here, and we'll talk about a few other things that we've had up on the Thrasher's Week blog this past week. One thing that we posted was a repost, actually, of one of the videos that came out last year on Psychedelic Pill called He's Always Dancing. So this is a really great video. If you haven't seen it, definitely check that out. Post it on the blog. A lot of great videos did come out of the Psychedelic Pill album, and certainly when that dropped, that we had a lot going on there with the book coming out, the tour coming out, the album coming out, the videos coming fast and furious, a lot of news, and so a lot of folks kind of missed that or kind of blew right by it when it did come out. But it's a very interesting video, and we've had a lot of comments on it, and of course that's always very fascinating for us to read those and respond to those and sort of watch a lot of the back and forth of that. So we assume that the folks are familiar with the song and familiar with the video, but in essence, as folks have pointed out in the comments, is that, you know, clearly, you know, the visuals that go along with that, you know, are very, if you will, pro-woman and do not put men in the best of light. And when you watch that, it all becomes very, very clear, you know, in terms of the way that stock footage is used. And of course, this is, you know, stock footage from, you know, earlier eras, a different time, you know, certainly, you see a lot of chauvinism that was, you know, quite apparent during our earlier eras, but you know, things seem to be moving along in a little more enlightened path these days, and certainly I think that's sort of the point of the video, as others have mentioned. But it was interesting because in the context of today, say 2013, even relative to when the video was dropped, I mean, it was actually quite humorous or weird or something, the way the comments came out when the video first dropped. When it first dropped, it was this sort of this outrage of how sexist the video was in terms of the objectification of women and all sorts of other charges against Neil Young and the way that he was using the song and the visuals. And you know, here we are, and things have calmed down a little bit, and, you know, folks see it in a different light. But anyway, I guess that's all what sort of makes what we do here kind of interesting, because people have all these different opinions. So check that out, you know, let us know what you think, and always love to hear from you folks out there. Otherwise, like we said, things have been quiet. We've had a couple other posts that we've put up. We had an interview with Elliot Mazur. He's one of Neil's longtime engineer producers, certainly a key player on his albums over the years, over the decades. So check that out, especially if you're interested in all the technical details of recording Neil Young albums. And then we had an interview that we linked over to from the Human Highway blog by an interview with Sherry Wilson, who is an esteemed Rusty type and who is about to publish her first book on Neil Young. It's actually titled Young Neil, and it actually focuses on his younger days up in Canada. Check that out. So otherwise, things are quiet, but we're looking forward to the March tour kicking off, and things should be quite busy and newsy. So tune in and check us out. Listen to WBKM. Check out the blog. We've got the podcast linked over on the right sidebar, so check that out and keep on rocking.